everyone. This is Professor Roger Flores of the Department of Electrical Engineering, Central Mindanao University, Musuan, Bukidnon. Today, we are going to continue our course, our subject, ES52 Engineering Management, and we will discuss Chapter 5, Staffing the Engineering Management. This is just the continuation of Chapter 4, which is the is entitled Organizing Technical Activities. So we were able to organize, we were able to create our organization or committee or subgroup or subunits, and we defined organizing using those structures, no? Organizational structures with specific authority, accountability. Okay, so here, this is putting all those structures, no? Putting staff or putting human resources on that structure that we created in that Chapter 4. We have this Chapter 5. Okay, so this is one of the function of the management, or the manager, engineer manager, to put or assign somebody or to evaluate somebody suitable for that specific position that we created in previous chapter. Okay, so we have these contents of Chapter 5. This is first one here that we're going to discuss is what is staffing. Let us define staffing, or we have that, no? So, and then we will also discuss staffing procedure. So, different procedure so that we will be able to assign, what to call this one? We are going to assign or put somebody with the proper qualification in the given position. Okay, so what is staffing now? Okay, so I've said a while ago, this is the management functions, no, that determines the human resource needs. Okay, so we are talking about here subordinates, we are talking about here employees. So we have to determine the needed additional or existing, no? So evaluating the human resource needed in our organization. Okay, so also we have to determine also, staffing also determines recruitments, okay? So, or to recruit, no? Determines number of employees that you're going to recruit or you're going to hire, no? So as we said that the first topic here is human resource needed. So you have to determine the needed resources, human resources. So now, if we're able to identify, then you have to recruit suitable person for that for that position. Then also from the recruitments or from the applicants, for example, sunod natin yung selections, no? So we have to select, we have to choose who will be suitable to that position. So according to their qualification, of course. Then the next is we have to train, okay? So we have to train. We have already our human resources, we have already our subordinates, we have already our employees. Then we should not leave them obsolete, no? We will not leave them becoming obsolete, but we should have to upgrade. We have to update their knowledge, okay? So we have to train them according to what specialization that they have, no? So next is develop also human resources, no? Develop, okay? So train for whatever assigned task for them. Then we have to develop them also, no, according to the technical knowledge that they needed, no. So in other words, just to just to combine, just to consolidate all these things, meaning staffing is the management functions. This is the function of the manager to determine human resources needed, recruits, selects, train, and develop our human resources for whatever job that we created in Chapter 4, the organizing technical activities. Okay, so this staffing also is undertaken to match people with jobs. No? This is undertaken to match people with job so that the realization of the organization's objectives will be facilitated. Okay, so it is understood that staffing should be done, okay, so that we will be able to match the people with the specific position, the authority, the degree of decision making. Baka mayroon tayong mga empleyado dyan na hindi qualified, okay, so pinasok lang natin dahil kaibigan, dahil yun, pariente, kaya nga. Pag mayroon tayong ilagay dyan sa certain position, then we must have to situate that this person or this employee or potential employee is having, okay, possess this qualification that match to that job. So that, of course, we will be assured that the objectives of the organization will be achieved. Okay, so that is what we call, that is staffing. So let's continue with the staffing procedure. Okay, so the first thing that you're going to do, being a manager, okay, or the president or the CEO of a certain organization, so you have to determine human resource. We have to do human resource planning. Okay, so human resource planning, this is where you will be able to determine the needed employee, the additional whatsoever, or within an organization you are going to hire, or you are going to place this one or reshuffle or whatsoever. No, so we should have to do this planning. Okay, and then we have also the next procedure here is, of course, if it is necessary to add employee, then we have to recruit. Okay, then as we said, according to the definition, you have to select, or selection process. Okay, so we have also induction and orientation. We are going to orient our subordinates and then introduce this, no, introduce to the workplace, to the actual workplace. Sino ba yung kasama niya? Sino ba yung makakasama niya doon sa trabaho? Yun, kailangan natin na ma-introduce siya doon. Okay, so also, we have to train and develop, no? Training and development, that is the next staffing procedure. But, of course, we have all this training, we have this development, then let us situate if they will be able to apply this one. Then let us evaluate their performance. So we have this, what we call as performance appraisal. Okay, so last part here is the employment decision. Okay, this is where people or subordinates may decide to retire, decide to transfer, decide to separate, decide to stop working with us, and so on and so forth. So this is the employment decision. So the last, this is the last part, no, of the staffing procedure, the separation. So later on, we will know that separation will be or might be voluntary or involuntary. So from the word itself, it is very understood. When we say voluntary, it is our decision of being an employee. Okay? So being an employee, they can decide, or they will decide if they can, they will have the intention to continue working, no? Or of course, we'll separate, might looking for a greener pasture, okay? Then another one is involuntary. When we say involuntary, it is understood that it is against their will, no? So maybe it will be our decision, being the manager, to let them separate from our organization. So these are the stopping procedure that we're going to discuss one by one. Okay, so let's begin with human resource planning. Okay, according to the definition of this human resource planning, this is a systematic deployment of human resources at various levels. When we say various levels of organization, at the top management, at the middle management, and the lower management levels. So, yan, diniscuss na natin yan yung mga previous na mga chapters yan. So, if you are at the top of the management, you have all the managerial positions. So, it is understood that the degree of decision making is very, very critical. You have a higher level of decision making. Okay, when we say middle, then of course you have this intermediate decision making, and the lower level are those in operations, no? Frontliners for our company operations. Okay, so next here is we have these activities to involve in human resource planning. So, okay, so it will be itemized here or enumerated here some of the activities that will involve in human resource planning. First one here is forecasting, no? So this is one of the important activity, okay, in human resource planning. So it is an assessment of future needs in relation to the current capabilities of the organization. So you have to evaluate our current capabilities, okay, our current capabilities, and then try to assess if it is needed to add additional employees, no, for the future. Okay, so that is why it is forecasting. According to our definition of forecasting, yung sinasabi natin na looking for the future, okay, thinking or concern with the future with respect to the current capabilities of our company. So pag makita natin na okay lang tayong mag-add ng mga empleyado, di gagawin natin. Saan ba tayo kukuha ng mga data? So from the previous, okay, maybe historical, no, or whatever, no. So we have those data so that we'll be able to forecast for the future. And also programming. This is another activity that involves human resource planning. So this is translating the forecasted human resource needs to personal objectives and goals. Okay, so claro yan, no? So ibig sabihin ng programming, whatever forecasted data that we have based on the history, based on the previous data, then we will be able to, we will try to translate this forecasted data related to human resource needs to achieve. Okay, so mayroon tayong programming dyan. So halimbawa sa faculty, no, so kailangan natin na i-program natin yan. So kailan ba ito mag-upgrade ng masteral, no, for the qualification? Sino ba sa next year or the next few years, sino ba yung mag-doctoral? So that will be able to, your faculty will be able to upgrade their qualifications being a faculty of the university. So yun, sino ba yung ipapadala natin sa mga trainings, sa mga conventions, so on and so forth. So those are part of the translation of the forecasted data. Okay, so next is evaluation and control. Okay, so this is monitoring human resource action plan, okay, and evaluating their successes or their success, no? So you have to evaluate also. So what happened to them? For those faculty, for example, as I have said, yung pinadala natin sa masteral tsaka yung pag-upgrade nila sa kanilang mga educational qualification. Ano bang nangyari doon? kailangan may monitor natin yan, no? So baka mangyari diyan, hindi na rin matatapos, hindi yan makatapos, so parang ganun. So we should have to evaluate and control them, no? So halimbawa, yun, sa kumpanya natin, pinadala natin sila ng mga trainings. So ano bang nakuha nila sa trainings nila? So it is it useful to their present position, to their jobs? Or otherwise, if it is not useful, then next time maybe we will not send them again. Okay, so ganun nga. So kailangan natin ng evaluation and control to monitor our their action plan or evaluating their success. Okay, so let's go back to forecasting. Ano ba talaga yung forecasting? Yun, nasabi ko na kanina na yung forecasting is concerning concerning for the future, for the capacity, the present capacity of the company, using the previous data, historical data, for example, to forecast, no? So we have this what we call last time series methods to forecast. So several company, we have some companies, no, that is using this time series method. Okay, so ano pa ba yung ano, yung time series methods? This uses historical data to develop forecast of the future. So yun nga, ito ang sinasabi ko kanina. As I've said a while ago that we will be using historical data, previous data. Now, mayroon ding mga tao na wala kong believe niya ng mga forecasting, baka hindi yan ma-achieve. Now, actually, even present time, no? So we have this example, we have this weather forecast, or it is also forecasting anyway. So but anyway, it is not related to management, but talking about forecasting. So as you can see this time, we will be able to determine our weather, typhoons, like for example the yung sama ng panahon. Even it is still very far to our area of responsibility. Okay, so yun nga, kasi ginagamit nila yung mga devices nila, no, sa pag-asa. So ano pa yung mga devices, paano ba nila ginawa yon? So they were doing this based on the previous data. Ano po ba yung mga bagyo na lumipas, yun, kaano kalakas, and all other historical data gathered, and then devised it, and we have these machines that were able to determine kaano kalakas yung bagyo, so on and so forth. So that is the beauty of forecasting. Okay, so yun nga, sa trabaho, sa management, then you should have to determine the performance, the data, or ano ba yung mga achievements, mayroon bang kaibahan doon sa pin-upgrade natin ng mga empleyado. Kaya nga, from this historical data, we'll be able to develop and forecast the future human resource needs. Okay, so what else? We have another method of forecasting, the explanatory or causal models, no? That they are attempts to identify the major variables that are related to or have caused particular past conditions, and then use current measures of these variables to predict future conditions. Okay, so you have this data, we have these major variables. So in statistics, in research, we have this what we call as independent variables. Compare this one, identify the independent variables, identify the dependent variables, then try to determine the and then based on these results of the comparison, association whatsoever, then we'll be able to predict our future conditions. Okay. So we have also regression models, no? Aside from that explanatory models methods, then we have this what we call as major types of explanatory models. So, ano po ba yung mga major types ng explanatory models? Sinabi natin na isa sa mga method ng forecasting. Okay, regression models. It is a forecasting method that examines the association. Yun nga, I mentioned kanina, no? Examines the associations between two or more variables. Two or more variables. So, mayroon tayong mga variables dito, dependent variables, then try to associate. Okay, compare between these variables. Okay, so that is one of the explanatory models. Okay, another major types of explanatory models, we have the econometric models. This is a system of regression also, statistical regression. And then using a regression equation, estimated from past time series data and used to show the effect of various independent variables on various dependent variables. Okay, so we have yung sinasabi natin na regression equation. Okay, this is more on statistical job. Okay, so ito, magaling mga researchers dito, no? So we will be able to apply sa mga research natin, comparing the effect or showing the effect of the independent variables on various dependent variables. Okay, so that is another type of major type of explanatory models, econometric models. Then also leading indicators, so refers to the time series that anticipate business cycle turns. Okay, so in the market, you might observe that there is a competition of products, no? Competition of products, that some of the products will say, okay, this product, our product is very good. This our product is above the leading, okay, the leading product. So, in other words, pag mayroong sinabi doon na nagki-claim na leading yung produkto nila, eh, ito pala, mas magaling pa pala sa pinaka-leading yun. Yun ang mga indicators, no? Taking all this data, okay, so we should have, we will be able to anticipate business cycles. So, halimbawa ngayon, halimbawa yung mga produkto, halimbawa ng produkto, yung mga cellphone, no? So, makita natin sa market, there is a competition between this model of this cellphone, no? This model of cellphone. Every now and then, kahit mayroon na lumabas ngayong taon, hindi pa matapos yung present time, mayroon din na namang lalabas na mga models. Kasi that is what they need. They have to compete so that we will be able to lead our product in the market. Okay, so that is the whatever results of this competition within the market in the business cycles, then you should have to use that data. Then that is one of the major types of explanatory model. Okay, so another type of or method of core forecasting, we have this monitoring method. Okay, from that explanatory models, okay, so we have this another type. We have this monitoring methods. Okay, these monitoring methods are those that provide early warning signals of significant changes in established patterns and relationship, so that the engineer manager can assess the likely impact and planned responses if required. Okay, so I think the most important here is these monitoring methods will, the purpose here is so that the manager have an idea, and there might be some precautionary, no? What we call this one as early warning signals for the manager to change if it is necessary, no? If there is something like problem in the process, then of course through monitoring, through evaluation during operations, then it could be used, this data could be used, no, for the future, so that we will be provided with a precautionary informations that we should not do this again, or there might be some corrections in the process along the way. You have to change, you have to improve, you have to make an additional, for example, if it is necessary in the process, no? Additional procedure in the process to check, to evaluate, and to make our flow, operations, operational flow, more, as much as possible, perfect. We have a perfect one. Okay, so that assists the likely impact and plan responses if required. Okay, so next step on the process or the staffing process, no, procedure, we have this recruitment. Okay, so this recruitment refers to attracting qualified persons. Okay, so here we have to attract most qualified person to apply, no, for a given position that we created in the organizing technical activity. So those positions here, we have to identify this position, then try to attract people to apply these vacant positions. But of course, later on we will know that we should have to follow the qualifications that match that this to match this person to this job that created, so that those who are best suited to serve the company may be selected. Okay, so we have here the sources of applicant. Okay, number one here, so maybe a source of one applicant is the organization's current employee. Okay, so actually it is more advantageous if mayroon tayong mga empleyado na qualified to hold this position, then it's better to hire them, okay, within the organization. Why? Because they know already our organization. They might know, of course, we are sure that they know the mission, the vision, the objectives of our organization, our company, for example. So the process, the procedure, so we don't need more trainings if we are going to hire, assign, or give this position to our current qualified employee. So one, that is why it is said that one of the good source of applicant is our current employee. Of course, we have this newspaper advertising. So in the newspaper, there is a portion there that we said that yung sinasabi nating classified ads. Okay, mayroon doon, maraming mga trabaho dyan na ipapapublish doon. Pero be careful with that, because mayroong mga trabaho dyan na maganda lang yung sinabi, pero yung actual na position mo hindi masyadong maganda, even the company. So, but anyway, maybe we will say that that is one of the source of applicant. Okay, so you have that newspaper advertising. And also, another source of applicant is schools, no? So, depende yun ng eskwelahan, no? Mayroong mga company na diretso na yan sa mga schools na mayroong mga magagandang reputations. Yung mga, like for example, good performing when it comes to board examination. Doon sila maghanap. Saan ba yung mga, sino ba yung mga placers ng mga previous board exams? For example, talking about engineering. Okay, sino ba yung nag-top 1? Sino ba yung, saan school ba yun? So, yun. Doon sila mag-advertise. So, that is one of the source of the applicant. Modesty aside, Central Mindanao University is already in the world market. Okay. So, kaya nga, mayroong mga company, mayroong mga organizations na magpadala ng mga invitations to our department, to our college, specifically to our any programs in the university that invited our graduate to apply to their company. Okay, why? Because of course, as I've said, modesty aside, yun nga, we are now the performance as a whole, our university performance is competitive world, makakumpit na tayo, pwede na tayo magkumpit sa world level na po. So, school is one of our source of applicants. Then, we have also these referrals from the employees. So, yun, referrals is very common that even the politicians here in the Philippines are fan of referring jobs to a certain company. Yun. Sino ba yung bagong empleyado natin? Oh, yun. Pinadala ni Mayor, pinadala ni Governor. Yun nga. So, but anyway, yun, hindi yan ang ibig kong sabihin na referrals. Referrals from the employees. Okay? Meron tayong mga empleyado na siguro alam nila na sino yung i-recommend nila. Okay, so pag mayroon tayong kailangang mga additional employees for that specific positions, maybe our employee can refer somebody to apply, no, being of course applicant to our company. Okay, so next is recruitment firms. Another source of applicant is recruitment firms. Rather than the human resource management itself will recruit a new employee, siguro mayroon makailangan ng mga busy yung mga tao dyan, tsaka malalaki din ang mga magagasta pag sila yung maghanap ng empleyado. So siguro ibigay na lang natin doon sa mga recruitment firms. But of course, being an applicant, situate that you will have to assured or kailangan natin ng assurance na yung recruitment firms is not illegal, no? So yun ang kailangan natin as an applicant. So kahit if we are the employer, no, situate that the firms that yung ginagamit natin na recruitment firms is walang problema sa DOLE, walang problema sa gobyerno. So, hindi yan illegal, ibig sabihin. Okay. Then, another source, of course, is the competitors itself, no? So, yung mga aplikante, yung nag-submit ng mga credentials nila directly to our company. So, yun, mga competitors yan. So, with bringing their qualifications, their experiences, their seminars, their transcript of records, and any other academic documents, then apply to a certain position, then those are some of these, what we call as competitors. Okay, so next is we have these selections. Now, we are now in the process where ito, medyo sensitibo din ito. Paano tayo o anong gagamitin natin na evaluation to select, to choose our employee or new employee or dedicated human resource. Okay. So, this selection, this is the act of choosing from those that are available, the individual most likely to succeed on the job. Paano ba tayo mag-select o mag-choose ng additional employee natin? Ano bang gagamitin natin na instrument? Ano bang basihan natin? So, yun. As I've said, this is one of the controversial part of recruitments or choosing new applicants or new employees. So, what is the purpose of selection? Okay, so this is to evaluate each candidate and or applicants and to pick the most suited for the position available. Okay, we have the most important word here, most suited. Okay, yung pinaka-qualified, hindi yung kasi kaibigan natin o kasi, ayun, recommended ni blah blah blah. So hindi po 'yon. Kailangan kung mag-silik po tayo ng mga empleyado natin, it should be based on their qualifications. Based on their when we say qualifications, maybe mga experience nila, yung mga academic documents nila, yung mga seminars na nag sinalihan nila. So those are some of the things that we are going to evaluate so that we will know kung they really suit for that specific positions. Okay, so next selection procedure. Okay, so we have here, it might be simple or complex. Okay, when we say simple procedure, it is just simply looking the face of the person. Okay, parang mabait naman to, parang magaling naman ito, okay lang, kasi yung trabaho eh, hindi naman complicated. Okay, so maybe talking about decision making, levels of decision making, hindi naman masyadong kailangan ng yung magaling na mag-decision. Okay, so halimbawa yung sa mga operational positions, no, so mga utilities, hindi naman siguro masyadong kailangan natin ng mga evaluation, mga complex evaluation pa, no, or selection procedures. So maybe an interview, okay na yon, no. So that is what we call a simple selection procedure. Okay, basta kailangan lang natin na basta yung position na inapplyan eh, hindi yung mga sensitibo na mga kailangan natin ng higher level of decision making process. Okay. Then when we say complex, then it will depend on the cost of a wrong decision. Okay. So ayun, opposite 'yan, no? Pag managerial na yung position, supervisory. Okay, managerial positions, supervisory, head of a group or a department or any organizations, then of course you might have a higher authority, you will have a complicated decision making, so you must have to use this complex. So when we say complex, you have those specific procedures to choose your subordinates. Okay. So ways of determining the qualifications of a job candidate. So ayun, kailangan natin, ito po ang ano, gagawin natin pag complex yung procedure natin ng selections, no? So look at the application blanks. Okay, ano bang ibig sabihin ng application blanks? These are the what we call as some of the example of application blanks is biodata. Okay. So when we say biodata, your CV, your curriculum vitae. So this an example or what do we mean by application blanks? Look at the curriculum vitae. Look at the biodata of this person. Yon, yung mga personal data niya, yung mga halimbawa sa family backgrounds, okay? So yon, kailangan natin 'yan. So andyan 'yan lahat sa application data up to the point that you have this reference person. Look at the reference person. Oh, yon, totoo ba 'yan? Sino ba yung mga reference person niya? Okay. So baka walang qualification din yung nag-recommend sa kanya or yung mga reference niya. Okay, so we have that. The next is try to evaluate according to references. And then sino po ba yung nag-recommend niya, no? So next is making these interviews. Okay, if you are the applicant, then you have some tips in attending or undergoing interviews. Okay, so now marami tayo dyan, no? mga tips, but unang-una, if you are given this schedule, then you must have to arrive ahead of the interviewer. Baka yung interviewee pa yung mas nahuli, mas nauna pa yung interviewer. Okay, so if it is a panel, then situate that you are ahead by these members of panel, no? So during interview. Then another tip is try to undergo interview with a presentable attire, no? So what is presentable attire? It is not necessary to use for the ladies your gown, no. So maybe simple business attire, okay? A simple business attire, it's okay. Okay, do not undergo interview with a very rugged face or rugged attire. So do not wear maybe maong pants, maybe slacks, no, or a coat, a tie, and it's okay, no. So basta yung kinalangan natin na presentable tayo. Okay, during interview, be honest, just be honest, no. If you know the question, then tell them what you knew, okay, or share to them what they knew. Okay, share to the interviewer what you knew. If you do not know, then it's okay. Just tell them that I'm sorry, sir. Honestly, I do not know this one, but I am very willing to learn. Okay, anyway, according to the definition of learning, it is a continuous process of education. It is a continuous process of learning. So hindi naman ibig sabihin na pag mag-graduate, gagraduate na tayo, pag engineer na kayo, ay wala na. Okay na 'yon. Never mind education, never mind learning. No. We should have, there is what we call as a continuous process of learning. So anyway, pag hindi natin alam, we should have to be honest to them. Hindi ko po 'yan alam, sir, pero or ma'am. So but I am very willing to learn. So, 'yun lang kailangan eh. Be honest during the interview. Pag alam mo, sabihin mong alam mo or share your knowledge. But if it is if you have a problem about it, then tell them that you do not know it, but you are very willing to. This is just an assurance to the interviewers, no, that you have those assurance that you are ready to learn. Okay, so aside from that, no, as I've said, just be honest, just be natural during the interview. Okay, and we have so many things, no, that you have to remember during interviews. Anyway, we will learn and we can research all those tips during interviews. Okay, so another as to continue here, another way of determining the qualification of a job candidate is testing. Okay, so we have several types of tests. We have the psychological test, we have the physical test, and so on and so forth. Okay, so try to let your applicants undergo testing. Okay, so as I mentioned, psychological test is one, no. This is very important so that you will be able to be assured that your applicant is what you call this one? Your applicant don't have any problem psychologically or mentally, okay? Because it might become a ano ba yung tawag yan? Maging a problema yan sa organization. So what is this psychological test? It is here an objective of this psychological test is this is the standard measure of sample behavior, okay, of a person, okay, sample behavior of a person. So that is the objective of the psychological test. Okay, one of the example of this or a procedure of this psychological test is aptitude test. This will measure the person's capacity or potential ability to learn. Yun po ang sinabi ko kanina na hindi ibig sabihin na kailangan yung mga aplikante natin alam nila lahat perfect, no. But there might be a possibility na okay, this is a potential person, but of course titignan natin kung gaano siya ka open. Okay, for when it comes to learning, okay, so we have this aptitude test, no, to measure a person's capacity or potential ability to learn, capacity to learn or potential ability to learn. Okay, so we have also this performance test. Okay, so this is a test maybe to measure person's current knowledge of a subject or the job, for example, or the given tasks, no? So anyway, we have this test, performance test. So that, yun, malaman natin kung mayroon bang alam ito. Okay, mayroon ba itong alam sa trabaho niya, magiging trabaho niya. So it should have, he or she should have to undergo this performance test. In any organization, we have several. Everybody should have to pass this performance test. Even faculty, every semester, students will do their evaluation, faculty evaluation. Now, our university this time is using this online evaluation. Okay, so that the university will know if this faculty is still performing well, no? Good performance pa ba yun? O baka kailangan na natin ng mga upgrading or updating for the student, for the faculty to become motivated, to be motivated in teaching, no? So we have that, and we have also this personality test. Okay, this personality test will measure the personality traits as dominance, sociability, and conformity. Okay, yung personality natin, ng mga empleyado natin, at malaman natin yan. Ito, matigas yung ulo. So, we should have to think of, okay, what we are going to do if, yung dominance niya. Ano ba yung mga traits niya? So, kahit hindi pa natin yan empleyado, kailangan natin, no? During selections, kailangan natin ng itong test na ito. Para malaman natin na, okay, tignan natin itong basihan natin. Okay, ito pala yung resulta ng personality test niya. Matitigas ang ulo, wag natin itong tanggapin. Baka magiging problema pa ito sa kumpanya natin, di ba? So, sociability. Baka ang kinakailangan natin na position, yung mga nandoon sa marketing. Tsaka ito, resulta ng personality test niya. Hindi, ayaw niya pala ng maraming tao. Okay, di ba? So, wag yan. Huwag natin yung choose natin kasi yung sa marketing, kailangan yung magagaling sa PR, personal relationship, no? So, that's it, no? So, you should have to do this personality test. Okay, so another one is interest test also. This kind of psychological test will measure person's interest in various fields of works. Bakit ba ito natin tatanggapin? Nahin, wala namang interest dito. Walang interest for the ad. Sasabihin natin, okay ba kayo ng trabaho na ito? Ano po bang kailangan natin? Bakit ito nag-apply? Kailangan ko po ng pera. Ayun, gusto mo bang magtrabaho? Ano po bang trabaho? Itong trabaho natin. Ay, ayaw ko pala ng ganyang trabaho. O di wag. So, during the applications or during selections of these applicants, try to also let them undergo an interest test. Okay, so all these tests here are some of the an example or procedure of this psychological testing. Okay, so another one is also, of course, the personal or physical testing, no, or physical examination. Okay, so ibig sabihin, this test given to assess the physical health of an applicant. Yung trabaho, yung position is nandoon tayo sa food production. O baka mayroon itong sakit. Okay, yun. Baka yung capability niya, yung physical condition niya, hindi fit doon sa position. So that is why we have to let our applicants undergo physical examination. Okay? So, kasi mayroong mga trabaho na kailangan ng physical conditions. Hindi naman natin ano yung mga PWDs, for example, pero mayroon naman tayong mga trabaho na hindi magagawa ng mga PWD, for example, PWD, yung persons with disability. So, paano ba natin, ano, ba tanggapin natin na mayroon naman siyang physical problem? Okay. So, of course, kung pwede lang, di i-hire natin. Halimbawa, no? Yung mga kapansanan niya, wala, hindi naman related doon sa trabaho. Ba't hindi natin tatanggapin? Pero mayroon yung mga positions na, okay, kailangan natin ng kumpleto yung tao. So, yun nga. Kailangan natin ng physical examination. Okay, next is, okay, that is physical examination. Next is, next procedure is, we have this letter D. We have this induction and orientation. So, ano po ba yung induction and orientation? So, let's start with this orientation. Ano po ba yung orientation? This is, if you have this new employee, if you choose new employees, or you have this one, you have your new employee here, okay, say to it that this new employee is will be introduced to the immediate working environment. Okay. Huwag mo namang sabihin na, pag ikaw yung manager, huwag mo sabihin na, okay, hired ka na, punta ka na doon. Okay, trabaho ka na doon. Okay, tanongin mo kung sino yung makakasama mo. Hindi. So, iba yun, no? So, hindi yan maganda. So, what we are going to do, we have this new employee, hired employee, then you should have to bring him or her to the actual working environment. Mas baka sabihin mo, okay, ito yung makakasama mo, ito si engineer, no? Ito yung supervisor mo dito, yun, ito yung mga kasama mo dito, ito yung trabaho natin. Okay, so you have to introduce your employee, your new hired employee, to your actual working environment. And sino po ba yung makasama nila? Sino po ba yung immediate supervisor niya? So that is orientation. Okay, next is induction. Baka ang alam lang natin induction, yung party. No? So yung induction is, your new employee should be provided with the necessary information about the company. Okay, so that is induction. You have to charge, you have to induct. Okay, this is our company, this is the mission, vision of the company, this is our product, this is the process, so that whenever this new employee will come out or to our to his or her working environment, baka tatanungin siya, ano pong trabaho mo dyan? Ano pong yung position mo dun sa company na pinasukan mo? Baka hindi nila masagot. Ano po ba yun? Hindi ko alam. Basta nandun lang ako, nakatayo. Ayun, yung binigay na trabaho, hindi. So, kailangan natin ng information related to our company, the process, the procedure, producing, what are the products, so on and so forth. The most especially is, what is the mission, what is the, so on and so forth. No? Yung mga pinaka-importanting mga information dapat alam ng bagong empleyado natin. Okay. So, ando na. Mayroon na tayong empleyado, nagtatrabaho na, performing well in the beginning, performing well, so on and so forth. So, ito nga, kailangan natin siyang matrain and ma-develop. So, what is this training all about? This is learning that is provided in order to improve performance on the present job. Okay? So, we have to train our employees, not only the new one, but of course, even those, yung mga old one. Okay, yung mga present employee natin, you should have to train them. Why? This is to improve their performance. And situate, trainings should made or should make them perform well in the present job. Baka yung training natin, wala palang maitulong doon. So, just spending money, additional money for the training, ang resulta, wala pa rin mangyayari, wala pa lang improvement ng performance nila. Okay, so we have these two general types of trainings anyway. So, trainings, training programs for non-managers. Okay, yung hindi nag-handle ng mga tao. Okay, so hindi yung mga supervisors, hindi yung mga managers, yung line managers, so on and so forth. So, ano po ba yung mga trainings na pwede natin ibigay sa kanila? So, we have this on-the-job training. An actual work situation under the direction of an immediate supervisor. Okay, so this is a job training which is working in the actual world of situation or working conditions. but it should be directed under directly with an immediate supervisor. O yung mayroong mag-supervise, baka magtrabaho sila doon, wala din sila, hindi nila alam yung gagawin nila. Kasi walang nag-supervise sa kanila. Hindi nila alam, tama ba yun o hindi yung ginagawa nila. So, actual workstation situation, and also under direct supervision of an immediate supervisor. That is on the job training. We have another one for the non-managers training. We have the vestibule school. Placed in a situation almost exactly the same as the workplace, where machines, materials, course, time constraints also are present. So we have that vestibule school. Eskwilahan po yon, training school. Maybe a short course, a short training course, no? So from the school, but situate that the school will provide, okay, similar to the actual place to work, or exactly the same as the workplace, which they provide machines, materials to be used during trainings, and they of course also given time constraints also to perform this specific act or task. Okay, we have another training that is applicable for the non-managers, the apprenticeship training program. Okay, apprenticeship program, that sometimes this is there is a confusion between OJT and apprenticeship program. Okay, what is this apprenticeship program? This is a combination of OJT and experiences with classroom instructions. Okay, so you are a combination of apprenticeship is a combination of working an actual work situation, and at the same time there will be a classroom discussion maybe before or after the performance or the OJT. Okay, so yun po ang ginagawa ng halimbawa yung sa mga doctors, no, yung mga estudyante ng medicine, yung mga nurses, bago yan i-deploy doon sa mga hospitals, mayroon pa sila yung mga discussions dito, ano bang gagawin nila, ano po ba ito, ang ganun, so on and so forth. Or after yung mga pag trabaho nila doon sa mga hospitals, pag serve ng mga pasyente doon, pagkatapos mayroon na naman silang mga evaluation discussions. Okay, so that they will be evaluated, no, kung mayroon ba silang nalaman doon sa actual na trabaho. So yun po ang sinasabi nating apprenticeship, no. So yun nga, so sa yun ang kaibahan ng OJT at saka yung apprenticeship. Yung sa OJT, trabaho ka doon, mayroon kayong supervisor na magtuturo sa iyo while doing your job. Apprenticeship here is mayroon kayong supervisor na mag-supervise sa iyo doon, magtatrabaho kayo doon, at the same time mayroon din kayong mga classroom discussions. So that those are some of what we call as training programs for non-managers with regards to this apprenticeship program. Okay, next is we have this special courses. No, this provides with emphasis on education rather than trainings. So this is more on this might be a special course, a short course that you will give this to your employees. Okay, so you are going to program or your employee to, okay, go with this courses, short course. Okay, enroll with this short course. And this short course is, of course, purely classroom discussions, purely theoreticals, no? That emphasizes education rather than actual working in the field or in the workplaces. Okay, so that is a special course. And then, so we have this. Next, we have the training programs for managers. Okay, so, ano po ba yung mga training na kailangan? Hindi ibig sabihin pag manager ka na, hindi na yan, wala na yan. Wala na yung purpose na yan. Alam ko na yung lahat. Manager na ako ngayon eh. So, hindi po. Mayroon tayong kailangan ng mga trainings to improve also your performance being a manager. So, you have some classification of trainings here. Decision-making skills. Because you are already a manager, then try to improve your decision making skills. Now take note that as we discussed our chapter 2, I think we talk about decision making, and it is said that it is okay, it is understood, it is understandable that manager can have this erroneous decisions, no? Erroneous decision. It is understandable because you are only human being. But of course, being a manager, do not rely on that statement only, because of course, mawala yung good reputations natin pag lahat na lang yung decision natin ay mali. So we should have to improve. You have to develop our skill in decision making. So this is one of the training that you're going to do. So we have some methods here, the in basket and the management games. Okay, when we say in basket, of course, we will be given certain situation. Okay, and dyan kayo lahat. So try to do this activity. So let us see if you will improve your decision-making skills. And management games also is a part of during that training. Okay, this is part of a game. Okay, you will be given assignments, for example. Okay, this is your part. This is so on and so forth. Okay, so try. This is a part of a game anyway. So we know that one. So I will not elaborate that one anymore. Okay, so we have these case studies. No, you will be given data. You will be given informations. Okay, we will be given a condition. Okay, maybe an actual condition. Okay, this is the company. This is the name of the company. These are the people working in this company. Ito po yung problema nila. Ano po ba yung gagawin natin? So that is case studies. So at the end, being the manager, you should have to recommend or try to give idea how to solve their problems. So that is an example of case study. Another classification is interpersonal skills. Okay, interpersonal skill here, this is one of the classification of the training that will improve us our interpersonal relationship. Okay, kasi po, pag ma-manager na tayo, hindi ibig sabihin na, okay, you should have to adjust to me because I am your manager. No, you should have also to understand, be sensitive to your employees, your subordinates, okay? You are the manager now, okay? So we should have to improve also, be sensitive to the feelings, to the emotions of your subordinates. So that is why it is, you have also to improve and attend trainings related to social or interpersonal relationships with your co-employees and to your subordinates. Okay, ano po ba yung gagawin natin? You have these methods, role-playing. Okay, from the word itself, you will be given a role and play as with respect to the role given to you. You will be, as a role, you are the manager. As a role, you are the employee. As a role, you then do the playing. So let us see if your relationship with your group with that during the training is improved, so that we can see that your interpersonal relationships with your subordinates will be improved also. Then you have also another method here is behavior modeling. Okay, so we have that everyone is unique, no? Unique po tayo sa ating mga behaviors. So kailangan, you should have to understand, you should have to study, you should have to improve, and you should have to determine your behavior with respect to this. What is your performance? What is your behavior in your organization? Okay, or being a manager. Then sensitivity training also, this is very necessary. I mentioned a while ago, when it comes to interrelationships, interpersonal relationship, then we should have also to be sensitive with your subordinates, their feeling, their emotions. Hindi yung pwedeng bahala ka na, kahit ano yung problema, no? Problema nyo, wala kong pakialam dyan. Okay? Because whether we like it or not, those problems of our subordinates may affect their performance. Okay, baka mayroon kayong empleyado dyan na yung pamilya, isang membro ng pamilya niya ay nandun sa hospital. So, wala, ayun, nakatunga nga palagi kasi nag-iisip dun sa maybe sa anak niya or asawa niya nandun sa hospital. So, if you are a good manager, then try to be sensitive with that. Maybe sasabihin na lang natin, okay, mag-leave ka na lang. Kasi hindi mo naman ma-perform yung trabaho niyo kasi nandun ka na. Okay, okay, you can go home. Okay, just file a leave. Okay, ako nang bahala dito. Ako nang maghanap ng replacement mo for a while. So that, of course, para tuloy naman yung operations natin dito. Okay, just go home. Okay, rather than, ayun, palaging nakatungangan, na gano'n yan. So, baka madisgrasya pa yan. Especially if he or she is an operator to, for example, a machine, baka madisgrasya pa yan. Kasi wala yung isip niya doon sa trabaho niya. So, that is one of the interpersonal skills. Good, you must have a good interpersonal skill being a manager. Okay, so transactional analysis also, no? So how you approach or what is your performance if or what is your what do you call this one? Response if somebody will approach to you being a manager. Baka yung mga tauhan mo hindi yan nalapit sa iyo kasi palagi ka lang galit, parang mukhang galit. So mukhang stricto. Ayun, wala na. Wala silang magagawa. They very poor yung transactional performance niyo. So try to analyze this one also. So we attend this kind of training also. Another one is job knowledge, no? So how well versed you are with respect to your trabaho. Okay, so on the job experience and then coaching at the same time. Okay. So of course whatever positions that you possess or holding, then there might be some conduct trainings more on coaching also, telling you what you're going to do. Now it is not hindi ibig sabihin na minus tayo, hindi. Pag somebody will coach us, then that's a good. Okay, you must have to accept that positively because might be yun ang nakikita nila na magiging problema sa management natin. So hindi naman ibig sabihin na wala tayong utak, hindi naman. So kailangan lang natin ng mga ideas, no, from the others, no, experience, no, well trained or specialized person to coach us. Okay, then understudy also, of course, that is more on training which will based on some readings, for example, learnings, okay? So, related to our job. Basa tayo, study tayo doon. Okay, organizational knowledge also. So, within the organization. So, we have that one. So, being a manager, you should have to consider also your knowledge in the organization. Okay, so position rotation maybe as one method of this training. And then multiple management. Okay, meaning it is not specifically for a certain group. You will manage different groups or in the organization, committee of that organization. Okay, so you are not only managing this specific department. You might manage another group for this another task and activity. So you will be given trainings for that now. So that is multiple management. Okay, letter F here is the performance appraisal. Okay, it is measuring the employee performance, no? So we have this purpose to influence in a positive manner employee performance and development. Okay, so that we will know how you're going to influence the employee if, for example, he or she is not anymore performing well. So in a positive manner, try to influence them. Okay, then we have this to determine merit pay increases. So what this is one of the basis of giving merit incentives, bonus, no? So this performance appraisal is also used the performance of the employee. Okay, you are for those who are the result is outstanding, so this is your bonus, this is your incentives. If you are only very poor and then you don't have any bonus or you are any incentives. Okay, so that's it, no? So your performance will tell kung magkano yung incentives mo. Okay, to plan for the future performance goals. Okay, if you can say that they are doing well, then okay, of course, improve. Okay, step up your target, level up. Okay, your target will be leveled up, no? So for future performance goals. Okay, kasi pag alam naman natin na kayang-kaya natin yan, but hindi tayo mag-increase ng target natin. So ayun, performance appraisal is necessary. So determine training and development needs. Okay, so ano po ba yung mga weaknesses nila? Doon tayo, hanap tayo ng mga training development so that dahil kinakailangan na nila ito kasi hindi mayroon silang mga weaknesses dito, no? So to assist also the promotional potential of employees, so assist promotional potential, that will be appraisal. The performance appraisal is also used. Okay, so ways of appraising performance: rating scale method. We have the essay. When we say rating scale, we have all this 1 to 10. Okay, ano ba ibibigay natin dito? Ano ba ibibigay sa mga evaluator dito? 1 to 10. So baka, okay, 1 to 10, yung 10 yung highest, yung 1 yung pinaka-lowest, parang ganon. So kailangan natin ng skill. So essay method, okay. Bigyan natin sila ng topics to discuss and then try to read. Ano ba yung mga responses nila? In a form of explanation or in a form of an essay. So tignan natin kung nakuha ba nila yon based on their experience, based on their present conditions. Okay, so we have next, management by objectives method. Okay, so yung management performance nila, titingnan natin kung nakabase ba yun sa objectives or the goals of the organization. Kung nakuha ba nila yon, kung nakuha ba nila yung target, kung their performance is based on the objectives, so on and so forth. Then assessment center method. So more on assessment of the performance. Then you have this checklist method. Okay, done, or not yet. Baka marami yung hindi nagawa kaysa nagawa niya. So ayun. So you must have, that is one way of appraising performance. Work standards method. By the way, every time we know that in our organizations, in your company, you have your work standards and you set these standards prior to the performance of these tasks. So let us see. Okay, to evaluate them, to appraise them, then their performance, then let us see if what they did is based on the standard. Baka gumagawa lang sila ng mga trabaho na hindi nakabase doon sa standards natin. So standards could be the output, time, for example. Dapat magagawa mo ito within a week. Doon, naging 1 month na, hindi pa natapos. Those are some of the work standards. Then ranking method, this is according to your ranks. Sino ba yung pinakamataas na position? Mayroong mga pinakataas na mga position. Ayun, siya ang susunod. Malaki yung puntos doon. So yung doon sa baba, maliit lang yung puntos niya. So these are some of the example of the ranking method in appraising performance. And of course, the critical incident method. Of course, given the situation, yung baka critical yung mga situation na yan, ano ba yung performance mo doon? Okay, because that sometimes you are under pressure. Ano ba yung performance mo? Magaling ka ba doon? So, under kung mabigyan kita ng under pressure na situation, ano ba yung gagawin mo? baka marami kayong mga kamalian dyan. Okay, or if you are under pressure, na ano, yung tinatawag natin na rattle na kayo dyan. So, wala ka na magagawa. Walang magagawa kasi you are under pressure. Titignan natin yan according to your appraisal and performance. Okay? Then, employment decision. Okay, this is a letter G. This is the next procedure. So, either monetary rewards or promotion and or even transfer. When we say, we will give them incentives, we will give them bonus because we are performing well. So, that is your employment decision. Bigyan natin yung mga additional bonus, malaki yung bonus kasi maganda naman yung performance ng company natin. So, those are some of the example of employment decisions. And even promotions, no? So, when to promote? Okay. So, this is a yung pataas yung ranggo niya, yung ranks niya. Okay, how you're going to do? What are your basis on promoting? Okay, or demoting as worst comes to worst, no? Or transfer from this position or from this company to another company. Okay, so transfer. Like for example, yung mga teachers natin, baka ano ba yung basis natin ng ano ba yung mga decision procedures natin, decision making procedures natin, but itatransfer natin ito from those very far barangay to the population here. So dito ay ano natin, ano ba yung mga basihan natin sa mga pag-transfer, or from here going to the very far barangays, no? So those are some of the thing that you're going to study. Those are what we call as employment decision. Na-mention ko nga po ito kanina, demotion. This is a very worst, no? But i-demote natin yan. Okay. But i-demote mo ako? Bakit nandoon ako sa taas, ay binaba mo ako ulit? Okay. Ano ba yung decision? Ano ba yung basihan natin being a manager? So, kailangan natin yan. Okay? So, ang kailangan natin, there must be a legal basis or a data information. It is not just, ay, hindi na kita kailangan dito. Ay, ayoko na sa'yo. Hindi yan. Being a manager, you must have those legal data. Otherwise, you will be under legal battle later on. Okay, so this is the last procedure that we have. This is that sometimes, no, we might think being a manager, oh yeah, it is not a big deal for me. Madali lang yun. Tatanggalin, you're fired. Okay? Pero hindi yan. Being a manager, hindi yan madali. Pag sasabihin mo sa mga empleyado mo, okay, so I'm sorry, wala ka ng trabaho bukas. Hindi yan madali. If you are very sensitive manager or head of office, hindi yan madali. Okay, but anyway, separation is either voluntary or involuntary termination of any employee. Okay? So, no problem about voluntary, no? As I've said a while ago, it is not a problem if it is a voluntary. Okay, why? Because it is the decision of the employee not to continue working with us. Okay, so when it comes to relationship, interpersonal relationship, wala tayong problema dyan. Baka magka-problema lang tayo doon sa proseso, doon sa process ng flow ng trabaho, yung sa output natin, yung process flow natin. Pero anyway, hindi naman pwede na dire-diretso lang yan na mag-resign. Yun ang problema ng being a manager, yung sa involuntary termination. Kasi decision natin yan, decision ng administration yan, ng company. Hindi yan decision ng empleyado. If you are sensitive with the feeling or the your relationship with your employee, mahirap ito. Kasi kawawa naman yan eh. Especially if mayroon yung family na binubuhay. Yun lang yung trabaho niya. Baka walang trabaho yung asawa niya. Yun lang ang source of income nila. Tatanggalin pa natin. So, yun ang mahirap sa mga involuntary termination. But anyway, if it is necessary, yung tinatawag nating entrenchment, if it is necessary to, halimbawa ngayon, pandemic, walang mga trabaho, yun, nahihirapan tayo sa mga trabaho natin. So, yung gagawin natin is magtanggal tayo ng mga empleyado. So, wala tayong magagawa. Anyway, trabaho din naman yan sa human resource management, pero kailangan, if you are the manager, you have also those reasons, legal basis na kailangan natin na magtanggal. Ano po ba yung mga basihan na tatanggalin natin? Ayun, hindi lang basta-basta yung magtanggal ng empleyado. Baka pag yun, pag magtanggal tayo agad-agad, baka nandoon na tayo sa korte, baka mayroon na tayong kaso laban doon sa Department of Labor, magsumbong yan. So kailangan pag mayroon tayong mga halimbawa termination, involuntary termination, kailangan all those benefits being your previous employee, kailangan ibigay natin yan based on the what is stipulated in the law. Okay, so you have that, we have that labor law, and all those benefits, binigay ba natin yan o ibibigay ba natin yan? Kailangan yan. If we have this involuntary termination, that even voluntary termination, okay, voluntary na yan. So ibig sabihin, hindi lang basta-basta aalis yan. Baka several years na yan ang nag-servisyo sa kumpanya natin. So ibig sabihin, kailangan natin ang mga benepisyo niya. So ibigay natin yon based on what is stipulated in the law. So yun ang ano natin, kailangan sa during separation. Okay, so we finished discussing this chapter. So kailangan na yung sa organization natin sa engineering, no? So kailangan natin dito, we should be very what do you call this one? What we need here, especially during evaluation, okay? Planning, human resource planning, and all these staffing procedures, kailangan natin ito. Sasabihin ko ulit na kung mag-hire lang naman tayo ng mga empleyado kasi kailangan, dapat mayroon tayong basihan. Ano po ba yung qualification niya? Okay? Does it match to the job that we will give to him or to her? Okay, so yun ang pinaka-importante. Hindi tayo, ayaw, huwag tayong mag-hire ng empleyado dahil yung nag-recommend sa iya, kaibigan natin o pariente natin. So, ang kailangan natin dito, so that we will be able to attend the objective and the goals of our organization or our company, we should have to hire based on qualification. Thank you very much. God bless. And if you think that you learned something in our discussion here, staffing engineering organization, then try to subscribe my YouTube channel so that for the next discussion, the next video, you will be notified. Thank you very much. God bless. And amping.